hand by hand, and we want to obtain such decomposition where U is and U is in C M by M, and V is in C M by M unitary matrices, and S is a zero diagonal matrix S1, Sk, and the rest are all zero. This is in R M by N, and Sj is the square root of lambda j, and lambda 1 greater than lambda 2 greater than lambda k greater than 0 are the non-zero eigenvalues of the matrices AAH and AHK. We proved that such eigenvalues are real and are the same number and are the same eigenvalues. We just want to obtain such a composition. Non-zero eigenvalues of okay. So before to prove this, we recall briefly what happens commutative diagram for linear applications, where the matrix A here, you have the B belonging to B, belonging to B, the dimension of V is N. Let us call it, there are too many U and V. For the matrix, for V, V, H. So, let us call the vectorial spaces. We use another script, so we will not get confused with matrices. The dimension of V is N over C. So you fix a base BB, and then you get the coordinates X in Cn, n. Then you multiply by A, you obtain the coordinate way Ax. And these are in Cn. And then, if you fix the base in the space W, you obtain the vector W. This application from V to W is clearly a linear application. It is called a linear application associated to the matrix A between the, and W is in this vectorial space W, and of course the dimension W is N. Then the basis BV is V1 VN, and BW W is W1 WN. Okay? Then gives coordinates 0, 0, just 1 at the place the H. And so when you multiply, you obtain the H, the column in the place H of matrix. So this is the sum of I from 1 to n. So, one just, this is just recall, this first linear. Okay? So, what happens when you change base? If you change base, you have a new base here. And you can think, if you remember yesterday, I took, make a draw, the row like this. But we can think that the vector is the same, and since we change the base, and now we use the new base D, D prime V, we get some new coordinates X prime. Okay? So, who is D prime V? This is the base D prime 1 D prime N. And so we have now the matrix. Let us call the matrix V. I understand that there is a little bit of confusion, but V are the coordinates of the vectors of the new base in the old base. Okay? Let us call it N. smilings we need here. To pass from X prime to X. This is simple. Let us say, for example, we take the vector V prime 1. V prime 1 has just coordinate 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, because it's the first vector of the canonical base as coordinates in the new place. But since here we want the coordinates of this vector in the old base, we just want here the matrix D. Because if you multiply by V, you obtain the first column are the coordinates of the vector, the first vector of the new base in the old base. It's just now we make the same change. ID is the identity application in the space W. And then we fix a new base in P prime W. And then we get way prime, but what is way prime? Here, you have to get the matrix is, we call the matrix U, but it is not U, it is U to the minus 1. Why? Because in this direction, if you go in this direction, you go from new coordinates to old coordinates. And if you go in the other direction, this is the reverse direction. So since here you have V, you have U to the minus 1. Of course, U is the matrix, such that Uj contains coordinates of WJ prime with respect to the base B prime W, B W. Of course, B prime W I didn't write, but it's analogous. B prime W I can write here. Matrices, but different dimensions in general, M and L. This is M by M, and this is M by M. Okay? Okay. This is the picture. So you see, if assume for one moment that we have such the composition, U, S, V, H, exactly with this U and this V. Okay? Then, in the new base, what you have to do, the matrix K prime will be U, S, V, H, V, U, A, U, H. Why? Because these are unitary. V is V and U to the minus 1 is UH. So this cancels and this cancels. But of
course, this is not true for any change of variables. This is true, will be true. So if, more precisely, if we find a change of variables such that the new, the application with respect to the new basis, will be like this, then we are done. Because it means that after the change of variables, we get S. But if I get S is equal to U, is equal to A, V, U, A. And if I multiply on the left by U and on the right by V, H, I just get this decomposition. So my all this stuff, I just made all this picture in order to say that if I prove that I can change variable, I can change basis here and here, I set the matrix A, I set one application like this, I fix two bases in two spaces of dimension n and m over c. And then, if I can change variables in a way such that, with respect to the new base, I will get the, okay? So everything is clear. So, let us say that I fix, I take the standard canonical vector space, Cn and Cm, and the standard canonical basis, E1, Em. In this way, I am not to made to tell anything more about the vectors, because the vectors will coincide with their coordinates in a way. E1 will be 1, 0, 0, 0, E2 will be 2. So the basis, the spaces I fix here are Cn and Cm. And the vectors are indicated with the usual coordinates. So E1 is 1, 0, 0, 0, E2 is 2, 0, 0, 0, etc. Okay? So, okay. Now we can start the proof. Find same positive. So all eigenvectors are bigger than or equal to zero. So let us say that eigenvalues of this are lambda 1 greater than lambda 2 greater than lambda 3 greater than 0. Or eigenvalues will be repeated. If there are, for example, if eigenvalue 3 it appears 2 times, it will be counted twice. So each eigenvalue, I put greater than or equal to. Okay? And each eigenvalue will be repeated such as is algebraic, algebraic multiplicity. Okay. So this, we already proved that this K is the rank of A, that is the rank of AH, A, and it's the rank now what we want? We want to fix V1, VK orthogonal to such that A VH is equal to lambda H VH. So each one is an eigenvector for the corresponding eigenvalues. But we want more. We want also that V J VH is equal to zero if J is different from H. And this is clear that this can be done. Eigenvectors with respect to different eigenvalues, they can be so by spectral theorem, this matrix has a base formed by orthogonal eigenvectors. Okay. Now I want to VK plus 1 VN just they belong to the kernel of A, so they are such that A VH is equal to 0, so the null vectors, so they are the eigenvectors for the eigenvalue 0, and this is still true. And so we have, so this is true for H and J between 1 and N. H is different from J is different from H. I come just finish this space, I complete this space adding some vectors that are in the kernel space. So the last vectors, they are eigenvectors for the null eigenvector. Okay. Then I have to write down who are the vectors in the new base of the axis in W. Okay? So I have not necessity to write down V prime, because the original base was E1, E2, EN. And so this is the new base. So what I want to, I have just to apply the applications we found yesterday. So let us write down UH. What is UH? I want S, what are Sj? Sj are the square roots of lambda j, k for 1 from 1 to k. And I want uh the positive square root, is equal to S h to the minus 1, a u. A, B. We take these vectors. Okay? So,
remember, if I apply A A H to U H, what is this? A A H to U H, this is S A H to the minus one A A H A B H, but this is S H to the minus one lambda H B H, and this is S H. Lambda h dh, so we have lambda h divided by sh is sh a dh. So this is lambda h dh. So you see that we just sent an eigenvector. These are the applications we spoke about yesterday. We have an eigenvector with respect to eigenvalue h, lambda h, for the matrix AHA. And we send this to an eigenvector for the matrix AAH, that is m by n. That one was m by n. And this is true for h from 1 to k. Okay? And then the other vectors I send to 0. Okay? But this condition, how does it write down? A D H is equal to S H to H. What does it mean? It means that A B 1 is S 1 U 1. So this does mean that in the new base, A prime is exactly one, S one S K, and then you have 0, 0, 0. Why? Because change base, ABH, this is in the new way, since the old application signed the H in SHUH, in the new base you will send the H vector of the canonical base in SH, the H vector of the canonical base in the arrival space. So this does mean exactly this. Okay? But we are not finished. What we have to do? First of all, we just build in this way, we build U1, UH. And we didn't build any of
check that this base is orthonormal. Okay? Orthonormal. Of course, the age I didn't specify, but not just to say to be orthogonal. VH have to be or not one for H between 1 and n. Orthonormal. Otherwise, when I change, the matrix is not unitary. Okay? And so, what we are to say, to check, that these are orthonormal too. That these are orthonormal too, because if they are not orthonormal, the matrix on the other space is u to the minus 1, and this is not uh, 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 this, here you have u to the minus 1, but this has to be uh, otherwise what we wrote down before, because this means s equal to a b uh. If this is not uh, everything fails. But this is clear, why? If you remember, that applications, that were isometries. It means they preserve knowledge. So these are all of length 1. If these are eigenmetrics with respect to different eigenmetrics with respect to different eigenmetrics, they are orthogonal because this is clear, this is here. Eigenmetrics with respect to different eigenmetrics are orthogonal. But even if, let us say that lambda 2 and lambda 3 are equal, okay? Then U2 and V3 are also eigenvectors with respect to the same eigenvalue. But we build them in a way that they are orthonormal. Then the images, if you remember what we put yesterday, they preserve the angles. And so, since V1, VH are orthonormal, these are orthonormal. As for these vectors, you can choose as you want. You can finish the base of U as you want. The only condition is you have to complete the base in the way that such vectors are orthonormal, orthogonal to this, and orthonormal between them, and on length 1. Okay? So, to finish the base of U, you have no problem. Okay? And then we have the proof is finished. Then, just one remark. Just one remark. This remark will clarify something we told a couple of us ago. If you remember, VH1, VN, okay, cancel this because otherwise you get confused. I am referring to this space we just did. These are base, orthonormal base of where we that vectors, those vectors, of kernel of A. So, these were the last vectors. We choose them in the kernel of A. So, V1, VH, it is orthonormal base of the orthogonal space of this. But
who is the orthogonal space of this? This is the space remember that we are in the space, remember that we are in Cn, and we this already we do, but just to check, in Cn this is the space spanned by the rows of A conjugate. Conjugation does not alter the dimension, the rank, and so the length of the rows is n. A was n by n. Okay? And this is okay. And if you remember when we spoke about Chern-Lindes already. So what are now u h1 a so what are now u1 u h? This is the base of orthonormal base should be on the columns, the space spanned by the columns of A. It is the space with the same dimension, K, and the same rank of A. And then, this is the space by the columns. And so, u h plus 1, u m, this is orthonormal base of the kernel of A h. Why? Because if you reverse situation, you should start from the other side. Once you fix one, u1k, you have to complete with the kernel of AH because you were operating the matrix in the other direction. So you see, and these two spaces are orthogonal in Cn, and these two spaces are orthogonal in Cn. Everything. This can be useful in order to remember who is the orthogonal to the kernel of A. This is the rows of A conjugate. Why? Because practically here you see from here to here you have kind of H operator. Because here you go from rows to columns, and then you have conjugation. Okay, this is a better frame in order to remember. Here you have care of A, microstructure, and here you have care of A, and here you have rows of A, and here you have columns of A. You never have A twice in the same cell, and you have one conjugate. So here, A and A will do the job. Here you have A, A bar. And you have not to put H here because this is in, contained in the PS rows, and you have columns. Okay? So it is a help to remember this stuff. Okay? So, about this, we finished. So I want just to speak okay, I have half an hour. I will first of all I want to obtain a corollary. First question, before I write down corollary, Is this decomposition unique?
No, absolutely not.
Why? Take the identity matrix. This is UH, UI, UH. And you, here you can apply every unit matrix you want. Because I cancels and UH is I. So it's not unique.
The S matrix is unique if you write it down the proper way. We wrote it down putting the square root of eigenvalues of AAH in decreasing order. Okay, so this decomposition is not unique, but what I want to do. I want to do like this. Remember that S is belongs to R M by N. But I want to write down this matrix S prime M by M, S1, S2. And let us J it has one. Let us say that M is less than M. And okay. Actually, I don't even need here. Okay, I don't need this because I can put I can put K elements here and hold here. Va bene, ok. Sorry because I was not important call from here, but it could be important call from here because we just finished the selection. Okay, so back. I can put here K numbers. Okay? When you multiply, what do you obtain? So this is M by N. Okay? Why I have to put these only K numbers here? If M is less than or equal to N, I can put M numbers. part. I don't know if I cannot say that I can put m once, because if n is less than m, I can put k. But this, when you multiply, you compute as prime j. So this m by m, this just you have s1 and then all s2 meets this one. S2, sk meets this one. All other rows are zeros, and you get s. What do you get? S. So, I can write down my decomposition as like this. A, U, S prime, J, V, H. What did I gain? I gain now that I can write down U S prime, U H, U J V H. So what is this? This is square. This is n by n. And of course, since S prime is real and diagonal, this is self-adjoint matrix. This self-adjoint. You take the adjoint Hermitian matrix. You will be U S prime. Transposition does not do anything, and also conjugation does not apply. These are real numbers. U H. So this is self-adjoint Hermitian, better say Hermitian, and greater than or equal to zero. Semi and what is this? These are just matrices like okay, they can be, of course they can send some vector to zero, because they go from this, go this is m by n. U and V are just unitary matrices. Okay? And this J is just one copy of CK into from CM to CM. But beside this, this is just identity. Okay? And so we call this matrix, we will call Q. And this matrix we will call P. If I remember well, they are called P and Q. And this is so-called polar decomposition. One, two. Okay. Yes. polar decomposition. And what is this decomposition? I will write down now a parallel between complex numbers and matrices. So, real numbers what is a real number? It's by which matrices do correspond to real numbers? Hermitian matrices. Self-adjoint. If you take a number, you take the conjugation and self-adjoint one number, then real numbers greater than or equal to zero, they correspond to a mean matrix greater than or equal to zero. But this greater than or equal to zero, what does it mean? Semi correspondingly positive semi. If you put greater than zero, you would have greater than zero. Positive type. So what are imaginary numbers? They correspond to anti-Hermitian matrices. Means that when you take the H conjugate of transpose, you will get minus the previous. Yeah. When you conjugate IB, you get minus IB. So the algebraic form for a complex number is A plus IB. And we start from the number Z. And what is the number Z? It is our matrix A. A is our Z. And so, what is the Hermitian part? Plus 1/2 A minus 2. If you take the Hermitian of this, you will get A plus A divided by, so this is Hermitian. But if you take the Hermitian operator here, you will get AH minus A divided by, so this actually changes time. So this is the real part, this is the imaginary part. The analogous of the real part, if we have imaginary part, if we have numbers. In this case, this is the Hermitian matrix, and this is the anti-Hermitian matrix. There is only one couple of matrices of this kind, such that the sum of these
remember that here rho can be greater than or equal to zero. So here, this is a matrix number greater than or equal to zero correspond to a Hermitian matrix same, and this is same technique because S prime can have some zero. K can be strictly less both of prime times. You can have many numbers. And Q means the role of this other part. Actually, Q is not unitary. Okay, if you remember, we spoke about unitary matrices only for square matrices. But even if you want to compute QQH or QHQ, this is not identity. QQH or QHQ, they are square. What are they? They are 1 up to position k of the diagonal and then also. Then also up to n or up to n. But it's still generalization analogous to this. And up to the fact that I can change u here, if you remember, I could change u. But up to the fact of this, this decomposition S prime is unique, of course. And Q are in but this way. The only thing can change is okay. Of course, so we just finished here. We didn't cover many topics, but this was our aim was limited. And I covered more geometric